Hi guys, this is Matthias, and in today's video I'll be talking about the December patch and how it affects the fighter planes. And what's kind of funny about this is that I just recently made a video about flying, especially flying on Fjell 652, and how I've come to appreciate the AI gameplay in Battlefield 5, but especially on that particular map. And then, before that video was out, this happened. The December patch. Now, one of the most significant changes that happened was to the ammo capacity of the planes, but yeah, it's hard to say which one is the most significant change because there was quite a bit of them. Your weapons also end up on cooldown a lot faster now. It is, to me, especially bothering on the Spitfire MKVA, the one you see here. And one of the things that's important about at least my upgrades is that I only have one machine gun, and that's the tier 1 upgrade, the 8x.303 machine gun. Now there's no secret that there was issues with the air gameplay, but for the most part the issue was bombers versus infantry. Basically all that needed to be done was to reduce the splash damage of some of the bombs from some of the bombers, maybe some reduction to all bombers, I don't know, and of course the necessary change to make sure that bombers can't get a massive amount of kills in the beginning of the rounds. But aside from that, there wasn't all that much needed. Perhaps a slight buff to the AA or a slight nerf to the resistance of AA for bombers, and that would probably have been fine. Instead, we had basically a slaughter of the fighters just as well, and I don't really see why that was necessary. Now personally, I gotta say, I haven't spent much time with the air-to-ground gameplay in this game, and I know for a fact that if you are flying uncontested, infantry is very vulnerable even towards fighters if they don't have anything that gives them cover. But the fact is, except for Fjell, almost all the other maps have enough significant amount of cover that if this is taken advantage of, it is really hard for fighters to go on massive kill streaks. And of course, there can be a lot of discussions about what is good or bad, or what is fair and what is overpowered or whatever. But the amount of time that you now have to spend just repairing and resupplying and repairing again, it's almost like DICE wasn't interested in actually finding some kind of balance. It's more like they wanted us to be really, really bored. Now, to be fair, it wasn't all just negative changes. One of the changes that is positive is that we now have zoom on planes, and it works when we are in first person view, and this allows us to see infantry players that, at least to me, otherwise would be almost impossible. Now I'll show you a couple of examples of how useful the zoom can be when you're trying to detect players on the ground in order to shoot them with, especially with your primary gun. Now another thing that I noticed also after the patch, and this was also while playing infantry, was that this new spotting indication of players being suppressed are now more noticeable. It just seems to happen more frequently. It seems like the indications, they just appear more often. And when they do, they last longer. What is this? Oh shit. Now a big change is also that if you have any kind of rockets, wing-mounted rockets on any of your planes, you can have that on three of the four different planes, then they now have a massive long cooldown in terms of resupplying. Once you've shot them, it takes a long time until you can shoot them again.
I get my bombs back there? Oh, the maneuverability is much slower now, is it not?
So now, to my big disappointment, the changes of this patch had a massive negative impact to the air-to-air gameplay, the very part of this game that I have started to appreciate the most.
Oh shit, look at this! Are you kidding me? I'm almost crashing! Well, I shook that guy by doing that though, but holy shit! Oh, this is intense. This is very different. They've changed this up a lot. Planes do not behave the same way.
So now, when it comes to a chase like this, normally considered a straight-up dogfight, one of the most important upgrades you can have on your plane is the automatic leading edge, which, to be fair, I think that's on the German side. On the British side, the same upgrade, or at least similar upgrade, is called improved control surface. Or maybe it's the other way around, I don't remember exactly. But the problem that I see with the upgrade tree, especially when it comes to that particular upgrade, is that this plane, the MKV-A, which I consider being the fighter that is mostly specialized for air-to-air, on this particular plane you can't even have that very upgrade. So I'm not entirely sure what that means in comparison to the other three planes when it comes to turn rate. And the fact is that the more I look at the upgrades for the fighters, the less they make sense. The spotting camera is another thing that is really weird, and I was paying attention to it on my G6. I'm not sure if you can have it on the other planes, but the weird thing about it is that you can only choose the spotting camera if you choose not to have any of the specific air-to-ground weapons, which means that it doesn't serve any purpose. So yeah, you have a spotting camera, perfect to see the enemies on the ground, but all the weapons that you could possibly use in order to kill those players, well, they don't fit in the same line of upgrades. I don't think I'm the only one getting tired eyes and a headache from not being able to see my enemies.
Da drüben! Verdammt gefährlich!
Ho, ho, ho. All right. I think DICE just hates pilots.
Now, after the update, I had to go through some of my settings quite a bit. One important thing was that I normally play now with borderless instead of a regular full screen. And the main reason why I do that is that I constantly go into my NVIDIA settings in order to change the gamma up and down.
Come on, really? How long do you get stuck in the air ceiling? What? It's so... DICE. DICE, for the love of... What are you doing with your games, DICE? Seriously.
Now, when it comes to changing my NVIDIA settings, what it's about is that the default contrast that I have is 50. That's my just default on my monitor. And whenever I play a battlefield round, I turn it down to 40. So I lower the contrast by 20%, because the contrast in Battlefield 5 is generally just too high. What it does is that dark areas gets too dark and bright areas gets too bright. And I minimize that by lowering the contrast. But another thing that I keep doing while playing is that, depending on the map, I raise the gamma if it's a dark map, or I lower the gamma if it's a bright map. And like, for example, on Devastation, I raise it quite a lot. And if I'm flying on, let's say, Hamada, then I lower it quite a lot. Kind of strange how I feel the need to do that in a AAA title, but yeah, that's where we're at.
It's not easy to kill a bomber with this plane now. It's like, you just shoot and shoot and shoot and shoot. And they just keep flying. All right, I got it. I got it, don't worry.
Now I noticed, and you see at the end of this clip, how there was a lot of pilots that were struggling with the new settings or the new handling of the planes. Now, I'm going to end the post commenting here soon, but you'll hear some of the discussions we're having on the stream throughout the video as it continues. Now, quite soon in the video, you're going to see how I go through my upgrades of all four planes, and you'll see some of the reactions we have as we look at some of the changes that was made. Or, well, there was one change that was made, and it limits your options. Basically, that's what it's done, but yeah, that'll be explained if you just keep watching. Aside from that, the video will show you some of the experiences I've had flying the very first day of the December patch. Also understand that there is a bit of sarcasm when I say that DICE hates us. Anyway, I want to thank you all for watching, and I hope I'll see you soon again.
Oh! Was that a guy? I'm out of ammo! I'm out of ammo! I got him burning and I'm out of ammo! Alright, they did change the air gameplay quite a bit. Stop shooting me, I'm friendly! I didn't shake him. What is this? Oh yeah, give us less options. DICE really, really hate us. I think DICE really hates us. I can't see anything else than the fact that DICE hates us. DICE, what did I ever do to you? Why do you hate me? Okay, I see what they did. If you choose the middle, the middle path, you can't, you just have less options. That's what it is. If I would have chosen a different path here, like earlier I could have gone from this middle path, I could have gone to Nitros, but since I didn't do it, it wasn't reset. That's what it did. That's what the changes was. So that's what it did. Okay, so here's the change. This is the change. If you don't know exactly what was changed, I see it right away. If you choose this upgrade, whatever is in the middle, On your second upgrade, you have three choices, and one of them is in the middle. If you choose the middle one on your upgrade on the plane, you then have less options afterwards. You only have to go on the right side. Maybe there are some planes where you have to go on the left side, but you have only one choice after that. For me, it was only affected on some planes and some not. So it depends on. But once you choose the middle one, you can only go probably on the right side after that. Maybe there are some planes where you can go on the left side. It doesn't matter. Look, there's no line on the left when you choose the left path. See? There's only the right path. How you doing, Conrad? How you doing, my man? I just shoot him straight in the face and he's like, yeah, never mind. It's just 50 cal bullets. It's just like, whatever. Whoa!
He's doing that slow down technique all the time. All right, he died in the freezing water. You don't want to be there. Norwegian water is cold. Cold, I tell you. Holy shit. Everyone is chasing everyone here.
Be aware that we have lost objective Charlie. Attention, objective Baker has been lost. Objective Dog is now ours, soldiers.
Fortification got wrecked!